Warm boys, looks like it's gonna rain over the horizon, but got up nice and early to make fun of Landon this morning because he's always beating me to the barn. I get here at 6 and he gets here at 5:09 or something like that, so it's like 5:50, so I'm like 10 minutes ahead of his schedule right now. So boom, beat that. I just ran into the store. Pretty nice feed we got here for water tanks. Yesterday when it rained, the water tank was already filled, and we don't have like a gutter system that fills up the water tanks when it rains, because that'd just be stupid, because you'd have all that paint chipping and whatnot in your water tank. But I'm not sure how that happened, but yeah, we're gonna start with these water tanks. Let's see, windows. This used to actually be a dairy, that's why there's windows and there's holes and things everywhere. But it's no longer dairy, it's a steer operation. So that's a fun fact. Boys, we're gonna make that look nice. I'm gonna put on a jacket because it's kind of chilly. Boys, we're gonna do this here because we have enough time to do it. And Lance's still not here, so. I don't know if you see this, but just yesterday it rained like a ton. Didn't get any recording done because all we did was feed. That was it. So we got a ton of rain, 2.5 inches overnight. But we're gonna now scrape this out because it looked nasty. Pretty much it's just really wet, packy silage, and silage has the ability to seal itself. That's how we keep all the silage up in our silage, our silos, nice and fresh, because this top silo, the top stuff on the silo, keeps the bottom stuff sealed. Like a Ziploc bag, keeps the stuff sealed inside. So as soon as all the juices and like moisture runs out of the corn, and you chop it, there's still like 9% moisture in it. But 9 to 15%, I think. But that stuff still stays in there. That's why that stuff still molds if it's on the opening. But you still need that moisture, so it's not just leaves. So, it's a fun fact, but if air can't get to it because it's like a Ziploc bag effect, then it can mold because you need air to mold, so. Hey, Pablo, where's your friend? Oh, yeah, that's right. He's making me some babies out here. Yep, we put the bull back out here, so we gotta be careful. What are you doing? Wherever he is, he's somewhere out there. The bull's back out there, so we gotta watch our backs. It's a pretty nice bull, so. We don't really have to worry about them too much, but we still have to worry about them because it's still a bull and it's an Angus bull. So you don't want to trust any kind of, well, you don't want to trust any cows. And I trust these cows way more than I should. But especially the bulls, you should always be watching out, see where they are, making sure you're not making it mad by pissing it off, by standing by it, or getting in its way or something. But, we're waiting for everybody to come. I'm gonna do my mandor clean out of all the aisles in the barn that I do maybe 5 times a year because they get nasty. So, but in this first 10 feet, look at all the stuff we got already. Oh, you really can't see it. I'll put you back here. You guys can watch. You see all the stuff? There's just stuff everywhere. That's why we clean it out, because straw falls from the top of the roof and whatnot. So we're gonna clean it out. do this about 5 times a year. Cleaning all this shit. See, the problem is we don't get everything off the thing because we don't throw lime down. If we throw lime down, all the straw won't stick. All the poop. Good afternoon, guys. Just washed over to the barn to see Grandpa. Went out to the green shop. So it's about mid-morning right now. We're gonna drop him to skid steer and scrape that up. Finally dry enough to go out and chop some stuff. So finally dry enough to scrape. Put you somewhere. I think that's the fastest I've scraped the yard in a while. That was like 5 minutes. I'm surprised he didn't come back yet. It's starting to rain. So I knew it was going to start raining, so he was going to come back and not put too much in the feeders. But he hasn't. I think he's doing the steer side, but judging by the rain that's coming right now, it's going to be too wet. So, you know, tell me, I'm an OG at doing this kind of stuff. You know, judging by the 5 minute job I did, it's not bad for how wet it was. And I was gonna use it for bedding, as you see there, but I noticed that it was really, really soupy, and I'd rather let that dry out first and throw it on some nice fresh bedding. So that was just like a test. I still got all this area, they're still gonna lay in that. Tomorrow we'll bed this up again, because Landon didn't bed up what I wanted him to. I wanted him to bed up the entire inside and this outside. He only bedded up the outside. But, pretty good job, 5 minutes. I mean, so tomorrow that will all be dried out, and if we don't push it over across, because we got to start stockpiling manure again, because we have nowhere to put it out in the fields, then it'll be either stockpiled over there or used as bedding later this week. Pump the water, here he comes. All right, boys. Left to go green chop some more. I'm gonna clean up this yard. Thank you.
You boys are coming in with me now. Because it's been...
All the video clips I have ready from just today, I might just freaking upload a video for tomorrow. Jeez, I got like half an hour, like an hour worth of recording just today. You are being a YouTube star like me.
So, boys, pretty interesting day on the farm. I'm gonna post this video. Want to talk about that? If you like what you see here, consider subscribing so you can, guys, get some more content, see some more content when it pops up, and you'll always be notified when I upload. So, just gotta make this waters off. But, I mean, I like farming and you guys like watching it, so I guess I'll continue it. Well, I'll see you guys all later if I don't back into the 2+2.